postponed due to coronavirus concerns. Obviously, the football world has had a prominent impact due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, guys, both of these teams here today will be without notable players. For UNC, three defensive players, DJ Ford, Bryce Watts, and Javon Terry.
Michael Carter in at running back on a second down and relatively short. Howell. He will be hit and dropped back at the 32-yard line. So the first negative play because Josh Black, 85, gets in there. Ball will sit up at about the 35 now as Howell throws. Pass is caught, but a flag down at the line of scrimmage. Yami Brown making the catch inside Orange territory. So on first down and 10. Howell gets it to Michael Carter. Breaks a tackle inside the 30, to the 20, down the sidelines and pushed out of bounds. They will spot him around the 2-yard line. Some pressure. Howell stands in the pocket, throws to the wide side of the field, pass is caught. They need to get it inside the 33. Howell stands in the pocket again, pass is caught. Newsom Williams with the tackle.
Syracuse opts to bring pressure. Look at North Carolina picking it up. Love that from Javonte Williams. And Daz Newsom gets man-to-man coverage against the great Andre Sisco.
Ball will sit around the 11-yard line for Sam Howell, who stands again in the pocket, throws underneath. Garrett Walston, the tight end. Touchdown, North Carolina. And it did not take long for Sam Howell to post his first touchdown pass of 2020. Put it up in Sam Howell, doing what he did last year, just throwing touchdown passes. Outside slant is caught out over the 35. That'll be marked at the 36, so a first down for the Orange. Swing it near side. Mike Johnson hit around the 33-yard line in the play for the Tar Heels.
Carolina did a fantastic job of staying disciplined on this one.
Third down and 13. Bobble snap. DeVito coming near sidelines and just off the fingertips of Taj Harris. Return the longest allowed was just 5 yards. Daz Newsom back to return this one. He will call for the fair catch around the 24. Said he studied every game of Joe Burrow last year. That ball is picked off at the 33-yard line. Jones comes up with the football, and Syracuse is in great field position.
One-on-one with Yami Brown on a slant is draped all over him. Sam Howell has confidence in his receiver, but Melifonwu with those long arms at 6'2", sticks it in there.
7:41 to go in the opening quarter, 7-0 North Carolina. Pressure comes, DeVito steps away from it. Finds a little room to run and gets it close to the line to gain. DeVito takes it himself and he is stopped short of the line to gain. Damon Fox comes up and makes the play for North Carolina.
Reed. Damon Fox is able to get out and recover. It's a decent read by Tommy DeVito. Fox was kind of playing in between. In that situation, you'd like to see him hand the ball off, but you've got to pick one.
Two receivers to the near side. Hand it off to Carter. Nowhere to run.
Might even Michael lost Carter on the carry for the Tar Heels.
Dumps it off underneath. Both Corrales making that catch. Last year, both 40 catches on the year. Averaged over 41 yards a punt a year ago. Good hang time. Deep kick. That will send Johnson back to field this one, and now he's got room to run. Flags all over the field. Five-man rush, pocket collapses, DeVito goes down at the 25. First one there is Fox.
talked about the Brown brothers. Well, there's also the Fox brothers as well. You're going to see Tamari Fox just work his way through the middle of that defense. Excuse me, that offensive line. Close in on Tommy DeVito, and there's nothing DeVito can do but go down for the sack.
Nolan Cooney to punt it away to Daz Newsom. Daz calls for a fair catch, and he will field it at the 35. And they have, like, as he kind of said, paraphrasing, adult conversations about coverages. A couple of missed tackles as Williams gets it out over the 40. Spot him at the 42, and that's got to be invaluable as a coordinator, right? Pass caught underneath. Nice little dipsy-do move on the outside by Bo Corrales, which will gain the first down.
That's the whole bag of tricks right there.
Looks healthy to me. Here's Williams off that right side. He's powering his way inside the 40. Another first down as he picks up about 12 yards for Syracuse up front. Carter goes in motion. They'll swing it out to him. Syracuse plays it well, and they'll drop him around the 33-yard line. Won the job here in the preseason, and he will attempt this one from 50 yards away. Near hash mark. Good clean snap. Kick is on the way, and it hits the upright.
It was kind of surreal. Felt like yesterday when we showed up just to go through our walkthrough.
DeVito, nice throw to the wide side of the field. That pass is caught. Good enough first down. Taj Harris. It is the Hall of Fame right there. Storm Duck. DeVito. He's dropped inside the 35. Boy, the front four of North Carolina just caved in the pocket.
These third and long situations, North Carolina is going to bring pressure, and it was really up the middle. You get big number 51, Raymond Vahasek, collapsing the pocket, and there's nothing a quarterback can do. I mean, think about the great offensive.
Cooney with no rush, wobbly kick. Taken at the 21 and dropped there in Syracuse. Trying to dive on the football. Who has it? It will be Syracuse football.
Daz Newsom usually sure-handed. That one gets down, and the turf is slick because it's been misting a little bit at times. You've had some precipitation. The ball squirts around him. But he felt really confident with the interior of his defensive line, and they've been impressive so far.
Boy, a little delayed reaction by everybody at the line of scrimmage as DeVito, a little quarterback draw, takes it close to the 10-yard line. They'll hand it off. That will go to Jordan, and really no room to run on third down. So now you're looking at fourth down, and they needed to get to the 2-yard line. 47 of 54 in his career. From 37 yards out. And the Orange on the board. Probably wanted more, but they'll take the three here in the second quarter. Back to Keenan Stadium at Chapel Hill after this. Quick slant. Corrales tries to hurdle a defender. Will have the catch and the first down. Howell on one of those designed QB runs, and nothing there.
Was a designed pull. This was actually a good read by Sam Howell. Kingsley Jonathan is the read player on that. You just had a stunt where the tackle is.
Four-man rush. Pocket collapses, forcing Howell to run. He's to the 30 and tries to get that football over the 35-yard line. Done all that Dino Babers would want. This high-powered North Carolina offense, a little bit sluggish here in the first quarter and a half. Nakeem Johnson out over the 20 to the 22.
And has really done a great job of listening to them through all of this.
Pass caught by Johnson. That'll take it out over the 30. For more on what North Carolina's doing in that patch, let's go down to Taylor.
And I asked him about that. That responsibility. He's the only black head coach in the ACC. So did he feel a responsibility to say something? See the pass go out of bounds on third downs. And he really said.
Cooney, another good high kick. Newsom will field this one. And Newsom will get it out to just shy of the 25-yard line.
Well, and he feels like his move largely helped save her life.
And she's doing well now, thankfully. There's Carter. Boy, he just got tripped up. Five on the line for Syracuse. Carter coming near side. Little stutter step. Cuts it back to midfield and then some to the 45 of Syracuse. That is a big gainer. Brought down there by Coley. 22-yard pickup.
A little bit of a hold there on the edge. Maybe,
yes.
But a nice cut by Michael Carter to get up the field.
Syracuse up front getting the work done and destroying that play.
Well, Tony White called him ultra explosive, the true freshman, and looks like Carolina, now they're sending on the punt team, but watch him. This is a blown assignment on the offensive line. Somebody is supposed to account for him.
You know, not a whole bunch of practice time, and you get all this movement from Syracuse and a new look defense. It's caused some problems up front for North Carolina.
I'm pumped to see Notre Dame in the league this year. I'm also pumped that they figured out that the logo goes inside the numbers and not outside.
Yeah, Georgia Tech second year under Jeff Collins. Of course, Mike Norvell leading Florida State's team as he takes over. Third head coach for Florida State in 4 years.
It was like a long handoff. It's a really cool play design.
And then here goes Harris. He'll pick up some first down yards near the 45-yard line. That was a little Canadian football-esque. What? Pressure comes. DeVito feels it. Breaks a tackle. Dives for the 45, and he'll have the first down. Jazz Surratt, who we haven't mentioned his name much today. On third down. Flag comes out. DeVito is dropped around midfield. Tamari Fox, first one there for the Tar Heels. And a flag comes in. They ran into the punter, Nolan Cooney, and a flag comes out.
Personal foul, roughing the kicker, defense, number 88, 15-yard penalty.
DeVito, empty set, quick hitter over the middle as he hits Taj Harris, who breaks a tackle, stays on his feet, breaks another tackle. He's inside the 20. They couldn't wrap him up. What a run by Harris.
Sit at 164 pounds, but we've seen him do this time and time again. Somehow just manages to break tackles. The whirling dervish is able to. A matchup with one of these linebackers on the receiver. You see Taj Harris in the slot at the bottom against Jeremiah Gimmel.
DeVito rolls to his right. Nowhere to go, and he is hit out of bounds around the 11-yard line. Chaz Surratt chases him there. The 2018 Lou Groza Award winner and first-team All-American. From the far hash. And he misses it. Oh my goodness. We'll see if that plays out for Syracuse as they try to pick up the first down on third down and 7. And Chaz Surratt making the play. That is tackle number 8 for Chaz. Daz Newsom back to return this punt. Stands at the 32-yard line. But a flag down at the line of scrimmage. Fair catch called for. And catch is made. Not a whole bunch of big plays for this offense in that first half. Trying for one here, perhaps. Howell going up top, trying to hit the seam, and that one's picked off in the back end by Cisco. His 13th career interception. He's trying to find some room near midfield. He'll be tripped up there. Andre Cisco, the All-American, coming up with a big play.
Football, that's as a deep field safety. Sam Howell looks at Deami Brown on the post, and Andre Cisco reads it all the way. That's about as easy as it gets for an All-American like Andre Cisco. Fantastic job. Another opportunity that Syracuse has gotten.
Cisco had 7 interceptions. Quick throw. Taj Harris makes a man miss. Another man miss to the 30 and dropped at the 29. Leading returning receiver with 559 yards last year. He'll hand it off to Mackenzie Pierre. Jeremiah Gimmel making the tackle. 108 yards, no touchdowns, no picks. 4-man rush. He'll step up at the pocket and he will run DeVito falls forward inside the 20. It's all about the spot right here. DeVito felt the pressure, tucks it and runs to the 10, to the 5, and dropped there. It'll be first and goal for the Orange. Two receivers to each side. Jordan, the running back. They will throw it, or attempt to throw it. DeVito trying to bust out of that pocket. Nowhere to go, and he'll just fall down, and he'll lose a couple of yards. Jeremiah Gimmel chases him down and forces DeVito to hit the turf.
Secondary and linebacking core. There's nowhere to go with the ball. He doesn't have his first read to the top, tries to work back to the bottom of the screen, but those Carolina defenders are draped all over Tommy DeVito, and he goes down. And
23-yard field goal attempt on the way for Schmidt, and this one is perfect. A bunch of white jerseys, orange helmets at that line of scrimmage, and all moving around. North Carolina picks it up. Quick slant. Bo Corrales making the catch for a first down. They'll swing it out to Williams. Makes a man miss. Another one miss. And tossed out of bounds inside the 35. Nice block on the edge.
This play is made by Garrett Walston. A really nice job of cutting Andre Sisco, who just made a fantastic play. If not for that, Javonte Williams, because of that block by Walston, springs him.
Big hit on Howell. Gets the pass away down to the 25-yard line. Caught there by Deami Brown, but Howell took a shot.
Both Carter and Williams are so good in the pass game that they really still have the entire playbook open.
Yeah, combined to make 38 receptions last year. Big collision. Javonte Williams lowers his head.
To your top of your screen.
Looking that way, but Howell is dropped by Kingsley Jonathan.
A weird play because Howell pulls this ball and is looking for somewhere to throw, but I'm not sure Corrales or Newsom were expecting that. Although Walston was leaking out, maybe he was trying to go there. Walston tripped a little bit coming out. But
Cooper Graham will hold it. Kick is on the way. And it is good. So North Carolina puts three on the board.
Carolina's just coming off a 12-play drive. Syracuse cannot afford to put its defense back on the field quickly.
Surratt was picked up on his blitz attempt. Now he's chasing down.
When that's counted as a sack, because that's not on the line.
Daz Newsom will field it and run, but a flag comes down. Daz Newsom gets past the punter. Daz Newsom will take it to the end zone, but there is a flag down around the 33-yard line. Big hole off the left side. Michael Carter to the 20 and pushed out of bounds. Tar Heels off the left side.
It's a really excellent play design. You had number 88, Kamari Morales, going across the formation. The running back goes back to the side where Morales came from. And
35-yard pickup. Second read works for Howell as he gets it to Deami Brown, who sets up North Carolina now first and goal from the three. Handoff goes to Javonte Williams, who will stick his nose into the Tar Heel end zone for the six.
Power into the end zone, and Javonte Williams is really able to just walk into the end zone.
Because I think expectations are so high.
Well, I think that you see Tamon Fox again getting in the backfield. He's coming off the left side. A little stunt. Comes in and that is where Markenzie.
Greatest improvements, we say it all the time, week one to week two. Syracuse trying to put some points on the board as DeVito scrambling his way out to the 28-yard line. He needed to get it to the 35.
Both of these teams are going to get a lot better over the course of the year.
Daz Newsom will field this at the 15. Trying to find a little bit of room. And does so. Nice return by Daz out to the 31-yard line.
First time in a lot of these guys' careers that they're going to have the same coordinator in back-to-back seasons on the defense side of the football for Louisville.
They will get it to Michael Carter. Makes a nice catch, and he will get it close to midfield and have the first down. Syracuse defense has been out there quite a bit. 474 yards of offense. Oh, nice little pump fake, but nowhere to go for it. Howell has some room to run now. And here come a bunch of flags.
There are multiple flags on the play.
And we're lucky that Sam Howell's okay. Carter trying to set up a little screen that was sloppy, but turns into a clean play. Trying to get the corner of the end zone, and he'll be just shy. They will spot this, it appears, around the one-yard line.
Check out this play by Michael Carter. It was sloppy, but then this move. Oh, going in, I'm going out. So shifty in the open field. He has really been the biggest weapon.
They will hand it off to Javonte Williams.
Touchdown,
North Carolina.
Really well. When you're having to rotate and play as many plays as the Syracuse defense has the last few drives. Comfort there. It looks, you know, a lot like last year where the offensive line struggled a lot and DeVito wasn't able to get a rhythm.
Dumps it off underneath. Not nearly enough for the first down. Daz Newsome back to return this punt. He will field it at the 17. Boy, nice little move there. Sees a seam on the near side. Daz Newsome, he's to midfield. Boy, Daz has shown some nifty return ability today.
Is go live on special teams and cover and have to tackle in space. And both of these teams have struggled with it at times. We've seen some big returns, but Daz Newsome is one of the most dangerous returners in the conference and shows you why. The nifty moves, the speed. He had the drop there early, but.
Sam Howell, 24-33, 257. Steps up in the pocket and throws to a wide open receiver. Yami Brown, and he'll drive a couple of Orange defenders inside the 10, down to around the 7.
North Carolina has taken advantage of it. Here's the play by Howell to set that up. Steps up in the pocket, rolls a little bit to his right, and the pass is a little behind Brown, but it's a fantastic.
7-yard pickup makes it first down and goal, just outside the 5. They will go with Williams. Left side breaks a tackle into the end zone, and now North Carolina starting to open this one up.
Seems like they've been on the field the entire second half. The offense has given them 3 3 and outs. So it's really been up to this defense.
Another chance for us to get a look at Daz Newsome returning these punts. He has been spectacular back there. 37-yard return just a moment ago. See what he does here. Has a chance to field it at the 15. And he'll get it out over the 30 to the 32.
That were easy, but he executed too. So I think I would give him a pretty good mark on his performances there. There is many more crossers, much more stuff underneath that let his guys run.
And we'll get that to Henderson, and he stumbles as he approaches the 40.
They are building this program around him.
And Dave, let's not forget that when Mack Brown got this job, Sam Howell was committed to Florida State.
That's right.
That was his first big recruiting win, and it's only continued.
That are from this area,
exactly.
In the Charlotte area. Nice catch on the near side by Queely, and he is out of bounds. Actually, they're going to spot him out of bounds. Not a chance to talk to John Wildhack, the athletic director at Syracuse, before the game today, and I don't want this to be left unsaid. He is super proud, and there's a long way to go, of the way his team, 4 of 18. And that one is picked off. Culpepper's pass is picked off. Giovanni Biggers.
Time to get these guys in, playing a little extra. Here you have an opportunity to get an interception. You better celebrate it. And Culpepper throws that one behind his receiver. Biggers picks it off. And then celebrate. Bring that energy. Come on. The crowd's not going to cheer for you.
His teammates are jumping all over him on the sidelines. That was awesome. J.J. Jones in at running back, and he'll have the carry here, and nothing working. You know, we were talking about
freshman quarterback comes in, and look, on that graphic, we had that they get tested three times per week. We were told yesterday when these teams got tested yesterday, they took a test and a backup test.
Well, even the championship game is a fluid situation. It's scheduled for either the December 12th or the 19th. And you wonder what Virginia Tech's situation will do to impact that date. This could have been a whole different dynamic here in the second half, but North Carolina just too many weapons on the offensive side of the ball. Sam Howell finishes 25 of 34, 295. And North Carolina with 450 yards of offense. They hold the Cuse to 202.